The information provided in this video is intended for your general knowledge and is not a substitute for professional medical advice or treatment by your diabetes care provider or diabetes education by a diabetes care and education specialist. What is gestational diabetes, or GDM? Gestational diabetes is a type of diabetes that occurs during pregnancy. All pregnant women are usually screened for gestational diabetes between weeks 24 to 28 of their pregnancy. Women with high risk factors for gestational diabetes may be screened earlier. Many women can manage their gestational diabetes with lifestyle changes, including healthy eating, self-monitoring of blood glucose, physical activity, and medication if needed. In some cases, the assistance of medications is necessary to manage gestational diabetes. This includes the use of insulin, the preferred medication option in women with gestational diabetes. What causes GDM? Pregnancy hormones cause insulin resistance or block insulin's action to move our body's main source of energy, glucose, into the body's cells. Hormones secreted by the placenta, an organ responsible for providing nutrients to your baby, make the mother's body less responsive to insulin's action, contributing to insulin resistance. More insulin is needed to maintain normal glucose levels. If the pancreas is unable to keep up with the demand for insulin, gestational diabetes occurs. During the first 12 weeks of pregnancy, a pregnant woman's insulin needs are similar to what they were prior to pregnancy. Insulin needs will steadily increase after the first trimester and begin to double by week 24. During the last trimester, insulin needs may triple. Managing GDM. Gestational diabetes can be successfully managed by taking a team approach that includes you, your healthcare provider, and your diabetes care and education specialist. Once diagnosed with gestational diabetes, the best thing you can do for you and your baby is to keep your blood glucose levels optimally controlled. Maintaining optimal blood glucose levels is essential to avoid pregnancy-related complications for both the mother and baby. Keep in mind that time is of the essence because insulin resistance during pregnancy increases week by week. Ideally, your obstetrician or diabetes care provider will refer you to a diabetes care and education specialist, a healthcare professional that specializes in diabetes education, within the week after you are told that you have gestational diabetes. Diabetes education is considered such an important part of your diabetes care that medical treatment without it is considered inadequate. To learn more about diabetes education and healthy behaviors to manage gestational diabetes, contact Barnstable Brown Diabetes Education Services at 859-323-7391 or Diabetes Education Services at uky.edu.